Good morning, all. Today we are going to take up tax invoice under GST. As in the previous lecture, we talked about the assessment of taxes. Now we'll take up the tax invoice. As you all know very well, that invoice in general means any sort of receipt or the billing that needs to be done for whatever goods or the services that has been supplied. So in case when we are talking about the GST tax invoice, it simply means that we are generating the tax invoice. Tax invoice here means that the supplier who is supplying the goods or the services, he needs to generate an invoice which clearly mentions all the information in reference to the goods or the services that has been provided, that has been supplied to the recipient. And the invoice should contain all the relevant details about the supplies that is being done, like the value of the goods, to whom the supplies has been made, who is the supplier who is supplying, the GST number, etc., everything, plus the GST rate of GST that is being charged, and also the amount of GST. And you need to very clearly mention the categorically the GST type of GST that is being charged, like CGST, SGST, or IGST, or in case the UTGST. So an invoice is usually can say that it is a document issued by the supplier of goods or the services to the recipient and describes the details related to the supplies. So such sort of document, you call it as a invoice, or we call it as a tax invoice under GST. So when we talk about tax invoice, you know very well that it is being issued by the registered person, and each and every registered person who is supplying goods or the services or both are required to generate the tax invoice. Now let us further discuss the contents of the tax invoice here. See, in a crux, if I need to tell you that what all content that has to be there in the tax invoice, so in crux we can say it should have all the relevant details in reference to the supplies that is being made, like the name and address and GSTIN of the supplier. This is the very basic essential information about the you can say tax invoice that has to be there in the invoice format. Like who is supplying, what is the name, what is the company name, what is the address, registered office address, and what is the GSTIN registration number for the supplier. Then each and every bill should have its serial number. Serial number the supplier can fix up as per his own discretion, but there has to be some serial number in order to verify the documents. Then date of its issue. Date of issue simply means that when the bill has been generated. In future topics, we will be seeing when we will be taking the time and place of supply. Then we will be seeing the importance of date of issue of invoice. That plays an important role in you can say GST compliance. So date of issue is necessary to be there in the tax invoice. Then name and address. Or GSTIN number of the recipient who is receiving the goods, the name and address along with the place of delivery that has to be there, plus the HSN code. HSN code is basically the harmonized system of nomenclature code that is being provided to the goods, and accounting code of services for the services purpose. So each and every commodity, each and every service that is being provided or supplied to the recipient, it should be denoted by its respective HSN code. So HSN code is basically the code given to a particular category of the product. Like for example, if you take up, let's say leather goods, right? So for leather goods, there is, let's assume the for leather goods, the code is 07, right? So 07 is the code for leather goods. Now in that leather goods also, there will be different category of products. Like there can be leather jackets, there can be leather gloves, there can be leather wallets, purses, belts, etc. So each and every product will be assigned a separate code. Let's say leather wallets is being assigned 01 code, right? So 0701. Then under wallet also, if there is separate category, then it will be assigned a separate code of different types of wallets. let's say the particularly that type of wallet which is being supplied is 03. So the HSN code will come up to, this is a assumed coding system I am telling you. So this is how the HSN is also formed by the government. So now the ledger code for the wallet for that particular category of wallet will be 070103. So this will become your harmonized system of nomenclature code. So HSN code should always be there in order to denote that which category of goods or which particular product is being supplied. And so that that is why it is the HSN code is mandatory to be mentioned in the tax invoice. It gives a clear identification to the product that which product has been supplied. And if it is service, then you need to give the accounting code of services in your invoice. Then you need to describe about the goods, what type of goods are there. You need to tell that how much is the value of the goods that is being supplied. The value here means that what is the price at which the goods have been supplied, the rate of the supply, plus how much is the quantity that is being supplied, and ultimately you need to write in the final column that what is the final value of the goods that has been supplied. Then the rate of tax which is being applicable, the category of tax which is being applicable. Category here means, you know very well that if it is intrastate supply, then it is the different GST will be applicable. When it is interstate supply, different GST will be applicable. So whether the GST is IGST or it is CGST or SGST or it is UTGST, whatever, you need to mention that categorically, that which type of tax is being applied, what is the rate of tax, and under which category, how much tax is being charged on such supplies, as well as along with the rate, you need to also mention the amount of tax that is being charged. Then at the end, there has to be the total price, total amount that needs to be mentioned by the supplier, that how much the recipient needs to pay, then what is the place of supply. And if it is on the reverse charge mechanism, if the bill is being generated on the reverse charge mechanism, then that has to be clearly mentioned in the tax invoice. And then at the end, there has to be mandatorily, there has to be the digital signature of the supplier. Digital signature means you need to make the company name written over the bill, or you need to have the digital signature. Signature of the owner that needs to be mentioned at the end of the bill. So signature is a must at the end. So these all are the contents that should be there in the tax invoice. But let me tell you here that it is the contents which have been mentioned, but there is no standard format for the bill to be prepared by the supplier. Like, they can have their own pro forma, they can have their own design for the tax invoice, but just the thing is that they have to mention, they have to have these such details in the tax invoice which will make the GST compliance easy. So in that case, you whatever design you frame up for such tax invoice, but these all contents has to be there. Now for your reference, I have taken up a general tax invoice format here. This is a simple example of you can say tax invoice, where you can check whatever information, whatever content that we have discussed up till now has already been mentioned. As you can see, the GSTIN of the supplier, the details of the recipient, then under the main format columns, you can say it is talking about the description of the goods, HSN or accounting code, and how much quantity is being supplied, at what rate, then the total amount, then the different category of GST, like CGST, SGST, IGST, whatever is being supplied, then at the end, the final amount of goods, then final amount of taxes, then final signature, name of the, as we were talking about, the digital signature of the registered person. So these all informations have been considered under this example of tax invoice. So, but as I told you previously, that this is not the standard format, it is simply a example of the format. The supplier can have his or her own format, But yes, all the informations in reference to the GST compliance, like we have discussed, content of the tax invoice, that all has to be there in the GST invoice. Thank you. This is it for the GST invoice. We will be taking up more details in the next session.